Now for decrease in one stitch on the edge, and you could do this on both sides at the same time, just go ahead, take the end stitch off that needle, put it on the next one. This one may be a little bit harder to get, but you can get it. And then push your work behind. Take the yarn over the hooks as before, knit across. Now this is where I find that a lot of times it will not knit, but you could pull those forward. Again, take the end stitch off of that hook, put it on the next one. This one here is easier because the yarn tail is right here. And as you push the work behind, it opens those latches. Most times. Now this side here knitted pretty good, but this side here didn't. Just pull it off. If you need to decrease more than one stitch, what you're going to do is, now you're going to use the latch tool. And you'll only do it on the side of the carriage. So you're going to take that stitch off. You're going to grab the yarn tail, pull it through. You're going to take the next stitch off. Grab the yarn and pull it through both of those. Take the next stitch off. Grab the yarn and pull it through both of those. For as long, as many stitches as you need. And then I like putting it on the end, the stitch, the needle that has the actual last stitch on there. I did one before and put it on the empty needle to the left of the needle, and it left a little hole. So this way here, it's not going to leave that little hole. And oops, I dropped a few stitches, but I could go ahead and I could grab them. I may have to redo. Now I'm going to take this claw weight off because that could have been the culprit this time. I do need to redo these stitches up. Now I could go ahead and take my latch tool and actually put it from behind. But let me try something here. Okay, so this one was fine, so I could go ahead and do that one. Oh, actually I missed one way down here. Okay, this is where I could take my latch tool, get it in one of those loops, and just latch it up from behind. The only thing is I don't have another tool with this machine. And I have to be careful because these two stitches over here want to pop off. Now let me see if I could use my LK150 tool to get that on. Yeah, no problem. Okay, so what I need to do is just hand knit. I put the yarn in the hooks and then I bring the material forward, but I want to pull it down because that this stitch here is really tiny. Now that's a lot better. Okay, so in order to, let me try it this way. Let me take a clamp. That may not be heavy enough. So I'm going to take my latch tool, take the end stitch off the needle, bring the yarn through that, go to the next loop, take that off the hook, grab the yarn, pull it through both of those loops. Now, good thing this is just a sample because this loops on the end here are kind of tight. And it looked like this one undid itself. But I can go through the two loops, actually pull through three. This is just a sample, but if you're doing work on this, which you could probably get a baby sweater, an adult you're going to have to do in pieces and sew them together. Yeah. So let's see, 10, I'm really not back to the original 20 stitches. And I see why this fell over. The yarn was underneath the bottom of the cone. Okay, so again, taking the yarn, putting it over the needles, although I have one extra one there. It wouldn't have mattered because there's nothing there to knit it. Again, these two end ones did not knit. I just hand knit it, push the work behind, and continue with my knitting for as long as I need.